I'm just filming everything. I'm just keeping my camera on tonight.
He was a baby. And now he's teaching kids about drugs.
Yeah.
I can book the job. What he's about to take. Make him artistic and use those pictures for himself.
It is. Belt inside, we've done an awful lot to finish before the season starts. Follow us, we're going to go into that stand. We're going to take a seat and then I can introduce you into the stadium itself. over the years, the stadium capacity of the stadium has actually dropped, and that's because we've been replacing more areas around the stadium for anyone with accessibility needs. So this is the very first area that was ever set up in 1989 for people in the likes of wheelchairs, etc. So as you're looking around the stadium, you'll see lots of these areas, big platforms with plenty of space for wheelchairs to go with their companions, etc. And they're all around different parts of the stadium, so have a look at that as you go in. So capacity's come down, but it's given more opportunities for people to come and watch the game, which in our opinion is far more important. So follow me this way, let's go into the stadium.
You're going that way, yeah.
I'll say, just take a seat there, please. Yeah, on this point, please. Go on this road. So, stand, if you have a look above us, that's where your main canter will be, and that's where your commentators will commentate from as well. Only four main cameras are there, but there could be up to 23 cameras when it's being filmed. All around the stadium will be cradles, where they'll hold another camera, and in every other angle that is possible, there'll be a camera up there as well. Down to the Manchester United dressing rooms now. We have a little bit of a wait when we get down there, so I'll tell you a little bit about how what happens on the match day, then I'll let you go in and have some good photographs. Take your seats and I'll have a photograph in front of any of the shirts.
We'll have a light tweet.
for an hour in the day.
Yeah, well, that's it. So Mourinho brought this in, apparently, just for the, not just the bright white light and everything. It was all about the mood and getting the psychology. Yeah.
It just shows you the difference, the lengths that managers and teams will go to just get that.
It wasn't rehearsed that.
Yeah. Just to get that 1%, just to get that 1% difference.
Yeah. Cheers.
When did you come in?
Yesterday.
Not yesterday. You probably had to wake up
early in the morning. We just came in yesterday. Otherwise, we had to wake up early.
Guys, can I ask you just to part your waves, because he's going to come up with that, and I'm going to let it out on there.
This is where we're putting the health and safety test with Remington. So just sort of, I'm sure you'll all read the notes.
The alarms will sound.
Sign the display.
Hold.
Oh. They've cut this one.
Put some grass on that.
Yeah. It's like all of your lawns, isn't it? That's how it looks. So in a minute, Richard's going to line you up for the romance of here. We're going to play that this is the one, and I'm going to announce you into the stadium as if it was a match day. All right, so over to you, Richard.
Okay, thanks, Alan. Okay, before we do go and walk in those famous players' footsteps, I'm just going to a little bit about this tunnel. And I mentioned that we have two tunnels, the original tunnel that you'll see very shortly. We moved here for emergency access. Never been used on a match day, we hopefully never will, but we can open the doors at the back, remove the roller tunnel, evacuate people in the stand, let the stand raise up 25 metres in the air, just in case we ever need to get a fire engine or an ambulance onto the pitch. We test it, we know it works, we never want to use it for the purpose it was designed for. We utilise this area as well for after game TV interviews, so you may have seen these on television, with the lights being on, cameras here, interviewers waiting for the players to come off the pitch. The away dressing room now has been moved over to this side of the stadium, right behind the Stretford end there, because years gone by, before that dressing room was there, Manchester United used to line up on this side because of the tradition of lining up and coming out in front of the Stretford end. But now that tradition, like I say, is gone, so Manchester United will be invited here, and like I said, the losing team will come out and line up. Yeah. So we are going to have two lines, so pick your lines, doesn't really matter, one behind the other, but I would like to have a captain. Who would like to be a captain? Yes, sir, come on then, sir. You go. Okay, so you're right, so I need a captain of the losing team now, so who wants to be that?
One of the ladies, come on.
Yeah, Italian. Okay, choose your sides. One behind you and there. Just have a little bit of a gap between you. Don't get too friendly.
Win it in the tunnel. And don't forget, so what we want now, we're not. John, is it still you walking out here at Old Trafford?
Yeah, look, that'll never change. I think the best thing was that we had to warm up, obviously half the crowd was still in, so they enjoying themselves, so for full time, we started the game, came to walk.
Putting ourselves in the theatre of dreams. So
take it. I told mum to hold it, I take it.
Ja, uit de mond volgt, zei hij. Hij zei uit de mond volgt. Ja.